Hey everyone, and welcome back to Cyberpunk TV. Today we're playing a new game. Well, not particularly new game, but a game that's new to us. Dark Dreams Don't Die, Season 1, or D4. This game was at least partially written and produced by Swery65, who had a large hand in Deadly Premonition, which was one of my favorite games for the Xbox 360. So I've actually been, like, anticipating playing this game for a really long time, and I had to get over some technological hurdles to get it recorded. There is a PC port of this game for Steam, but my computer and it do not get along. Despite well exceeding the system requirements, it just does not run right. So this is the Xbox One port of the game, or original version, because it's not a port, and we're going to play it. I don't really know what to expect other than this game is more akin to a Telltale adventure in that there are quick time events and actions than Deadly Premonition, which was a lot like Resident Evil 4 if it were run over by a truck. But I don't want to knock that game because it is still my favorite game of, like, practically all time. And someday I really want to let's play it for you guys. But it's a huge time commitment, and it's really hard to capture from the 360. So I'm working on figuring that out. Maybe sometime in the meantime it will get backwards compatibility and solve all my problems for me. That, or I will pick up the Steam version of the Director's Cut and play that. Although, because that had some of the rough edges sanded off, I actually don't like that as well. Because it controls better, and why would you want that? Alright guys, let's play Dark Dreams Don't Die. I'm excited. Okay, so this game was originally made to work with the Kinect sensor, because Microsoft was crazy about the Kinect sensor back in the day. And I do not own one, nor do I want one, so this we're gonna play with a controller. Hopefully it's not too bad. It's a little bit strange, but it should be okay. Oh man, this game just got sexy.
This is a story of a man with a very strange fate.
I've grown wings.
I was just gonna say, this girl can't make it out of the prologue. She's too sweet. She was a cinnamon roll, too good for this world. And in sweary games, the girls like that don't survive. And that's kind of... Alright. The prologue, the day it all began. Alright. Whoa. Hello. What? Oh. Okay. That. All right. Okay. So we're in for a treat, I think. There's my dad. Why? Oh, here we go. Yep. There is my dad. I correctly assessed the situation. Can I grab stuff? Can I? No. But I can poke signs. Developed by Axis Games. Yep. This cursor might be too fast. I might have to reduce the speed again. I was worried that it would be too slow, but it is in fact super quick, and I don't want to over-control all the time. Yeah, press Y to highlight something. Read all the observations to get a check mark. Okay. Use hand to highlight. Okay. Oh, I see. We'll get the hang of this yet. There. We're on a buoy. Grab the credit medal. Okay. Grabbed. Push the sign. Push. With right trigger or square. Okay, so grab and push. All right, grab all the credit medals. Look around. Ooh, that's a little janky. Not a super big fan of that. It's also backwards, weirdly. All right, whatever. Turn on and observe the man standing on the lakeside. Use R to turn. Oh, hold on. Grab, push snowball. Grab another metal. I am going to, hold on, right now, I'm going to do that. I'm going to go and adjust that speed because that is too fast. If I were a professional, I would go back and reshoot the entire beginning of this Let's Play, but since I'm not, return to game. Go. Yeah, that's much better. Push, 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 push. Okay, so, alright. Like, so, that's weird. Alright, let's go out and observe the man. Hey, what's up, dude? He's looking at me. Seems worried. He's always nice. Love you, Dad. I love you, Dad. Alright, so, where are we going? What are we doing out here? Like, what's the purpose of me? Move closer to the owl. Oh, the credits owl? Alright, cool. Press R forward to move forward. Wait, what? Oh! Okay, that makes sense. I can dig that. Grab some stuff. I can also just touch the footsteps, which I think I like better, because it gives me kind of a idea where I'm going. Thin ice! You think we should go back? Because we should probably go back. Alright, well. Can't say I tried. Alright, let's go forward one more. It's super weird because grab is left trigger, which really kind of throws me for a loop. But I think I will get the hang of it. It's not too tough. Push the owl? What kind of rude human being would push the owl? I don't have any. Alright, whatever. Here we go. Boop! Aw. Press Y to observe during cutscenes. Aw, it's a beautiful, cute, soft owl. This girl does not understand how birdwatching is supposed to work. Like, you can watch birds, but you're not supposed to touch birds. Oh, man. Yeah, come on, Dad, let's go. Whoa, there's like a frozen deer carcass here. I didn't even notice. Fell through the ice and then couldn't get out. Look at that, that's kind of scary. Dark dreams don't die. Oh man. I sure hope that's the title song. Oh, I'm so excited. What is going on? Okay, what is going on? I legit just fell from nowhere into a kind of horrifying bloody tub. Stay in character for the best synchro rate. Strawberry flavor.
I didn't see you again this time either.
Oh man, is that how our main character talks? Oh man.
Little Peggy.
My scar aches. My old scar. I like that, being able to interact with stuff in the cutscene.
My name is David Young. Former NOC with the Boston PD. And now a detective who searches the past. My likes include 100% de agave tequila, My dislikes are mainly drugs and chewing gum.
You dislike chewing gum?
2 years ago, someone killed my wife. Since then, I've been using every second of my life to solve a case. Using a certain, very special power.
Alright. Get out of the bathroom. Okay, that's not too bad.
It's been broken since that day.
Interacting with objects costs stamina.
Little Peggy.
Oh, geez. I'm having a super weird moment.
Everyone has their own place to work. A small desk in an office, a molten hot factory, a quiet library, the register in the supermarket, or in the middle of an intersection, in bed, on a golf course, a kitchen. For some, it's the whole town.
Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. You should not play pretend with guns.
From the day she died, this has been my place to work.
Okay, maybe she was trying to show me something. Like, show me the angle of the... I don't know. I have no idea. There's no justification.
A gift is an expression of emotion. The person who sends it wants the feelings to be understood. Sometimes, however, those feelings remain in a slightly different form. I call these forgotten treasures mementos.
Okay, a stiletto worn by the librarian at the BPL. Perhaps it was a gift from a lover. Has a name on the back, Dominic Bean. Mild-mannered librarian by day, at night she lured men with her wiles and sold them drugs. Maybe the center of this shoe was one of her victims. Either way, she wasn't D. Wait, is there a way to go down more? Scroll? Oh, there we go. This memento has lost its power. Okay, so like that's how we get visions, is we use a memento, and then once we've seen its vision, it doesn't hold any more power. Are these all mementos just in a big-ass pile over here that he's been... I sure hope not. That's kind of gross. The sink is messed up. There's the door. Is there anything else to be seen here? I guess not. Let's go. Out into the living room, then. Well, I can assume it's the living room.
No results this time, either. This case is in the clear.
Vision? Press and hold Y to use vision. Whoa! Okay. There's a file. I see. There's a bunch of stuff in there. So I'm going to do a bunch of stuff that isn't that before I go and do that. Yeah, it looks like my refrigerator. Let's get out of here. Oh, wait, what? Oh, cool. All right. Vision costs something, doesn't it? I guess. I don't know. All right, let's get out of here then. I'm kind of getting my bearings, so I don't have a lot to say here, but okay, so drinking restores your vision and food restores your stamina. That's fair. All right, well, let's go look over here quick. Did I leave a burner on while I went and tripped in the bedroom? That does not seem like a good plan. I guess, like, do I live here? Or, like, is this somebody else's house? There was a hamburger in the microwave. Let's go mess around, I guess. I'm going to avoid this table because I know that going on there is where I'm supposed to go, and so I'm going to go fuss around first. Because look at all this cool stuff. Yeah, let's put on a record. game. Oh, there's game songs from his other games. There's some stuff from Spy Fiction. All right, that can just be cool. Couple of records. There's my crazy board. Oh, extra cases. Oh, okay. Ooh, I have to figure out a way to not accidentally go into the menu every time I look at something. Grab. Okay, now how do we get back from here without... Yeah, so back. I want to just close, so I have to push start. All right. Oh, this game is a little bit clunky, but I'm kind of excited. Oh, fortune cookie. Hey, coffee. I'm just going to drink all the beverages. Swery and his detectives do like their coffee. Can't really say anything about that. Sure, let's have a fortune cookie. Oops, right trigger.
An ancient troll. They apparently wipe their butts using leaves.
In ancient Rome, they wipe their butts using leaves? What does that mean or have to do with anything? Scrapbook item 3. Alright, well, we added an item to the scrapbook. Workings of the brain, neurons and synapses. The brain is formed from a complex neural network. The network is created from specialized cells called neurons. Each working is a functioning unit. These neurons carry electrical or chemical signals. When a signal is transmitted inside a single neuron, they are exchanged in the form of electrical pulses. However, when signals are passed between different neurons, they're exchanged in a chemical form via neurotransmitters. The part containing the neurotransmitter is called a synapse. If anything goes wrong with this part, neurons will be unable to correctly pass information between neurons. This can lead to a variety of illnesses. Problem with synapses can both be congenital. Oh, I'm an idiot. I was cognogenic. Congenital and acquired due to injury. And may be introduced temporarily or chronically by taking specific drugs. Dynamic Sports Magazine. That is a dynamic photo. Okay. I don't think I'm going to read all of these unless they seem relevant. So this is just a quick reference that Canada is in the Olympics this year. For hockey, or at least that year, whatever that was, 2001, whenever that was published. This one might be more interesting. Twilight Report Number 1, Spontaneous Human Combustion. A person can suddenly burst into flames and burn up in a short space of time. Do you believe in the existence of this phenomena? There was a bizarre occurrence in Boston last month. A university student out during the weekend partying with his friends suddenly enveloped in flame and burned to death. As shocked friends looked on, the victim's body was quickly consumed by fire. Once the flames were extinguished, all that remained were the tips of his hands, and the rest of him were reduced to charred black ashes. That isn't all. Boston has seen a series of unexplained events in recent times. I'm planning on heading down there and investigating these bizarre incidents. My next report will likely come from the ground in Boston. Look forward to my findings. Yeah, I'm all right with that. That's a little bit spoopy. Dude, what did it say? I gotta go look. Hold on. Oh, nope. Turn back around. I want to look at this. What does it say? It says huge mite versus blue baby. All right, what else have we got? Hey, I can push that. Amanda likes it. So wait, is Peggy our girlfriend? Or who's Amanda? Hey, there. What? His tail is what? Potato chips. I will grab those potato chips. I'm gonna push that squirrel. Bye, squirrel. It's nice to know you. TV. Okay, the remote doesn't work. Let's go do it ourselves.
Uh-huh.
Detective Cat cartoons. Sebastian the Sleuth.
Hey, Amanda.
Oh. Amanda's our cat.
Do you want to watch too? We're just at the best bit.
Little...
Why does he call his girlfriend Little Peggy? I does not understand. But she was definitely pregnant in that vision. I have no idea. All right, well, let's go examine the file on the table. That should be fine. Wait, what is that on the floor? Oh, no, those are just balls of paper that have been there. Never mind. All right, so we've checked pretty much everything out in here. Let's go back to the kitchen. I like being able to walk all the way over there. That's pretty cool. Let's go sit down and look. I don't want to drink just yet. How about we look at this picture?
Did you hear about David's wife? Man, they were just married, too.
I heard it was revenge for one of his investigations.
Sure sounds like the way they operate. Sending a deadly message.
That sucks. Peggy Young. She was positive for drugs. Real blood.
I have no memories of that day.
Huh.
When I came to, I was already lying in the ICU. The only thing I do remember are the words that little Peggy whispered as she died. Look for D. Who is D?
Look for D.
Those words keep spinning in my head. At the time, with no compelling evidence, the case hit a dead end. I quit the BPD. However, under the right circumstances, I now have the capability to solve even a dead-end case.
Dominic Bean. So he's just tracking people with
I'll
initials of DB.
In my power to find this D. I swear I will. And when I do, oh, Peggy.
Whoa.
Amanda?
Amanda? Hold on, I need to have a drink before I see humanity. Hopefully, like, the door will still be knocking after I do this.
There's only one thing I need after work. Tequila. Straight up. Nothing mixed in.
Just monologuing here. There we go. Tequila. 100% synchro rate. Nice.
The perfect stimulation for my lead-filled brain.
Whoa.
You always look so happy drinking that. I wish I could have a drink, too. Does it really taste that good? Maybe I'll just try a little. Oh.
Okay. Well, she was definitely pregnant. She was drinking cranberry juice and chewing bubblegum. All right. We should let the person in or fight them or whatever is going to happen here. This door, right? Yep.
What am I doing?
Wait, what door? Oh, that door. My bad. I was, like, trying to run away. Here we go. Let's go over there. Man, that door has got some holes in. Hello?
Whoa.
What is going on? Whoa. Oh God! What is going on right now? Pushed Y a lot of times.
Gotcha. You can't escape now.
This is Amanda.
What?
She just suddenly started living here one day. She sometimes goes out and gets food for us. And that's something of a lifeline for me, as I don't really go outside. Just who she is, though, well, my memory holds no answers.
What? So, like, it's not weird that my...
Yo, David, everything shipshake?
As you can see, Teddy.
Someone definitely got the jump on you.
Forrest Kaysen, a detective with the Boston Police Department, and my former partner.
Forrest Kaysen?
He still helps me out nowadays in my search for Dee. He's both a client and a source of information. He gets whatever I need.
Women are always trouble. Doesn't matter how old they get, trouble.
Fighting with Diana again?
Like you wouldn't believe. Women, men don't stand a chance. Don't come and see me, actually means get right over here. But then, leave me alone, just means, well, leave me alone. How am I meant to make sense of that? Tell me, David, please.
Option one, Cafe Suri 65. This one.
You know you love it. You've got the stomach for it.
What?
My stomach is stressed out quite enough. Thanks. I was a fool to ask you.
Man, my bad.
Once feared as the mighty grizzly, detective among detectives. Now he's more like a big teddy bear.
What's the point of the place?
Teddy, what's this?
So, tell me, David, have you heard the news about that airplane accident, huh?
Access Gate Airways Flight 117, struck by unexplained lightning? No one's talking about anything else right now.
We might be looking at the real deal. I've got the good stuff for you this time.
Oh man, I'm so excited. Oh man, it's like I'm on my own crime show. Here we go. Antonio? What, these are the people that are in the show that I haven't met yet. Super excited.
A passenger simply vanishing from an aircraft mid-flight. Does that sound possible to you?
Not really.
Antonio Zapatero, otherwise known as Rabbit. He's a courier who only carries real blood. This one promised to provide evidence after being brought to Boston. Evidence that may well have led to the ID of the source of real blood. But then the lightning struck, and in the confusion, he vanished.
He escaped somehow?
No. When I say vanished, pretty much what I mean. Like something out of a magic act.
So, clue me in. What makes this one the real deal?
The name of the boss he was going to give up? Apparently starts with the letter D.
Oh man, you have my attention.
This courier might have had evidence revealing the identity of D. So, interested yet? Let me ask you again. A passenger simply vanishing from an aircraft mid-flight. Does that sound possible to you?
Almost anything is possible.
I'm like not good at playing my character.
In the first place, isn't it?
Glad we're on the same page. The courier had the evidence with him. I tell you, there's got to be a third party involved somewhere. From the evidence I was able to bring, this particular item is the most interesting. The owner of that badge was involved in this incident. Well?
No doubt about it. This is a memento.
Great. It's yours then. Let's hope it's the last one you'll ever need.
All right, the Bloody Marshal's badge, a piece of evidence relating to the case of the vanishing courier. It belonged to the Federal Marshal Derek Buchanan, who was killed while transporting the courier in question. Using this should allow me to dive into an airplane aboard which is D, the key to my wife's murder case. All right, well, that would be awesome. Wait, we can dress people up? Go to the main bathroom and dive into the past, huh? Well, all right then. Let's see, we've been playing about half an hour. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause right here, and we will dive into the past next time. It's been fun, guys. Hope to see you soon.